All right, today being 21st of June 2020, we'll be looking at another aspect of chemistry, still under introduction to chemistry, but this time around we'll be looking at nature of matter. Nature of matter. My lesson objective, by the end of the class, students will be able to state the meaning of matter, state properties of matter, state the types of change that matter undergo, state classifications of matter. Now we'll be looking at meaning of matter and physical states of matter. We'll be looking at the physical states which matter can exist. Now, matter can be defined as anything that has mass and can occupy space. Take note of that word, mass. Or you can also define matter as anything that occupies space and has mass. Underline that word, mass, not weight. Matter can exist in three states, which are solid, liquid, and gas. Though scientists have detected the first state of matter, which is called plasma state. Plasma states exist in star at a very high temperature. You may also call it electrical state of matter. Now, you can see the diagram of solid, liquid, and gas, and of course, plasma states. Let us quickly look at the properties of matter. We are going to look at them one after the other, properties of solid, liquid, and gas, like that. Now, the first here is properties of solid, or we call it characteristics of solid state of matter. Number one, they have fixed mass, they have fixed volume, they are fixed shape, they are incompressible, you can't compress them. Particles of solid vibrate and rotate about a fixed position, take note of that word, fixed position, and they are very, very dense. Very, very dense in the sense that they are hard compared to other states of matter. Now we look at liquid states now. Liquid state, they also have fixed mass like solid, they have fixed volume like solid, but they do not have fixed shape. They take the shape of the container. They are incompressible, just like solid. Now, particles of liquid, they vibrate within a restricted space, not fixed position now like solid, a restricted space, and they are less dense. They are not as dense as solid. Now, characteristics of gaseous state of matter. Gaseous state of matter, they have fixed mass, like solid and liquid, they have no fixed volume, they occupy the volume of the container, they have no fixed shape, they occupy the shape of the container, and of course they can be compressed. We say they are compressible. You can compress particles of gas. Particles of gas move at a very constant great speed. I mean, their movement is random at a very great speed, and of course they are very, very less dense. They are the least of all the three states of matter in terms of density. Now we look at a very vital point, changes in matter. Changes in matter can be classified into two. We have physical change and we have chemical change. Here is a table showing the difference between physical change and chemical change. First on the table is that physical change, how you can differentiate it from chemical change is that physical change can be easily reversible. Why chemical change are not easily reversible? You can only reverse them by chemical means. Under physical change, we discover that no new substance is formed. When matter undergo physical change, no new substance is formed. But when matter undergo chemical change, new substance is always formed. Under physical change, there is no change in mass. There is no change in mass of matter. But under chemical change, there is a noticeable change in mass of matter. Not accompanied by heat under physical change, but under chemical change, it is always accompanied by heat. Now we look at a very, very vital aspect as well, examples of physical changes of matter. Number one, we will see melting of solid to liquid, an example of physical change. Freezing of liquid to solid, an example of physical change. Vaporization of liquid to gas, an example of physical change. Liquefaction of gas to liquid. Liquefaction of gases to liquid is an example of physical change. sublimation of solid to vapor, an example of physical change, magnetization and demagnetization of ion, separation techniques like fractional distillation, evaporation, crystallization, all these are examples of physical change. And they are easily reversible. Now we look at examples of some examples of chemical change, which are not easily reversible. Number one, burning of substances. Take for example your wood. When you burn your wood, it turns to charcoal. You can't get your wood back. They are not easily reversible. Number two, dissolution of metal or limestone in acid. New substance is formed. They are not easily reversible. Chemical decomposition of food in the body, like digestion of food in the body. You can't get your food back once it is digested in the body. It's an example of chemical change. Rusting of iron as well. Charring of sugar. When sugar is turned to charcoal, that's the meaning of charring of sugar. It's an example of chemical change. You can't get your sugar back. And of course, dissolution of metal in acid. A new substance is formed entirely. It's an example of chemical change. Thank you for your time. Please take out time to solve this evaluation based on what we have learned in today's class. And the evaluation is very simple. We mentioned three familiar processes slash changes which you know to be physical changes and chemical changes. We listed that earlier. Number two, list three differences between physical change and chemical change. You also saw that table. Number three, classify each of the following as physical change or chemical change. Boiling of egg, burning of kerosene, melting of wax, rusting of iron, digestion of glucose in the body, dissolving of iron in an acid, distinguishing into physical or chemical change. Number four, state with a reason. State with a reason in each case whether each of the following is physical change or chemical change of matter, as dissolving common salt in water, burning of petrol, digestion of glucose. Thank you once again for listening. Next time, we'll be treating another very important topic. I'm CEO's tutor and talent manager. Victor is my name. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.